So very good evening to all the participants here today. Just wanted to, give a little bit of a brief introduction about the journey. Here today we have Baking Heritage Matter, Action Through Learning. So this is a platform that we've created to discuss how we can actually make a difference, make a change on ground really through our teaching and learning process. So this journey of our program, EMARC in Built Heritage Conservation, started in 2017. And through this journey, we've had interesting opportunities where we, in some cases, created certain ripples. In some cases, we made some splashes. And a lot of these initiatives have taken shape, in a fruitful form today and closing the loop, from where we started. So the most important achievement today is that we have our students who've over the last two batches of our students as the center stage today. And it's not us, the faculty, who are bringing this to you today. It's the current students of EMARC BH and at the same time, the just passed out batch from 2018-20 who bring in their motivation, their passion, through the presentations of their studio work and the live projects that they've been involved in through the process. So today we have our four students from the batch 2018-20, which is Samriti Singh, she's here. We have Manisha Jain, we have Mridalini Singh, and we have, we're going to have Tejaswini joining in. So these four are going to be presenting two projects. And at the same time, from the 2019-20 batch, we have Savar, we'll also be anchoring the event, and we'll have Samvedna presenting as well as Shriya presenting, two projects that they've been part of. So there's a lot that we have to say. There's a lot that they all have to say, but we have asked them to control it to the time that we have. So without taking much time, I will hand it over to Savar now to take the session forward. Thanks, Savar.
Thank you so much, ma'am. Good evening, everyone. This is a student and alumni-led webinar where we will be presenting, as Parul ma'am mentioned, the various initiatives of EMARC Built Heritage at School of Art and Architecture, Sushant University, where we have tried to engage with some live issues regarding the built heritage of Gurgaon. Just a reminder, may I please request all of you to kindly keep your mics on mute and cameras off to conserve bandwidth and also to ensure a smooth experience. We welcome your comments and queries. So please type any questions that you might have in the chat box. We shall address them towards the end of the webinar. I would also like to take this moment to welcome our Dean, Dr. Vibhuti Sachdev, and all the faculty members who are here with us today, along with all the participants, my colleagues, and also take a moment to wish all of our teachers a very happy Teachers' Day. And thank you for all the invaluable contribution that you have made to our growth as heritage professionals. Now I would like to hand it over to Samriti Singh and Manisha Jain, fresh graduates and passionate heritage professionals, already having started their professional journey. They will be talking to us about the various initiatives SSA has been a part of, and also will be speaking about the Kaman Sarai project in Gurgaon. Over to you, Samriti and Manisha.
Good evening, everyone. I will be taking you towards the initiative which was taken in the studio, which was sustaining heritage with the case of Kaman Sarai in 2019 and how that made the difference. I would request Manisha to present this PPT. Okay, yeah, it's there. So Kaman Sarai in Gurgaon is situated within the hustle bustle of the heart of Gurgaon. From medieval times, sarais and inns, they were built when journeys were done by feet or bullock carts. So taking considerable time, it was a resting place on the way. So people used to take break from their long journeys of trade, and Kaman Sarai was said to be undergone various changes in terms of use with change in time. So farmers used to come here to sell their crops and grains in the market which was present near. So Kaman Sarai has a significant historic value, since it is present in this area for more than 100 years as an icon and as a landmark as well. So it represents the architectural value from British period and various layers from other periods as well. So for that purpose, the project was conceptualized in various stages, like the documentation work was done, research and, you know, establishing significance of Kaman Sarai was done, even the assessment of physical condition, use, services, management and testing of material was also done in the studio. Manishu, can you move the slides, please? Next. So eventually, development of conservation actions and strategies were made, and details of individual proposals, like we were proposing a vocational center, a book cafe, exhibition area, along with a park for kids to play. So when we were going to the site for recce and assessment work, people living around, vendors, shopkeepers, they were taking interest in the conservation of Kaman Sarai as they feel the connection with past from this historic precinct. So because there were so many schools around the precinct, so we thought that it would be better to start with the younger generation. So therefore, we celebrated the 100-day challenge, which started with SSAA's Heritage Watch Day on 18th January. In a boys' school which was present just in front of Kaman Sarai. So the highlight here was the activity Soch Ki Udaan, which was basically, there was an aeroplane which was made out of a printed paper, which had a term defining heritage in every fold of it. So therefore, along with that, there was another activity which was carried out to suggest with the post-its, the interventions which are required by kids inside the Kaman Sarai precinct. So they were very enthusiastic for proposing a playground, an exhibition area, and, you know, these kind of things. So they were very enthusiastic about proposing this thing, these things in front of their school. So initially, these children, they were not even aware of this Sarai, which was present just in front of their school. So they, that became something of value to them. They started, you know, ideating. So we started that process of thinking in that generation. Also, where, you know, they now look at the spaces with a new perspective and realizing that there's a story behind a structure and, you know, the value is embedded there. So for that purpose, we met stakeholders like mayor, MCG commissioner. So initially, you know, they were proposing the demolition of Kaman Sarai and making a multi-level parking there. So we tried really hard to change their narrative from saying that there's nothing left in Kaman Sarai to actually saying that, yes, it is heritage, because the difference, you know, we made there. So then this Nukkar Natak was a great medium of spreading the message out. Manisha, next slide, please. So there was a news coverage of this thing, and, you know, interviews were taken by news reporters for the same thing which happened there. So these small news clippings, these changes, these, you know, small achievements, and, you know, how they are making a change in the larger public domain. So, you know, we were able to, you know, there was a little buzz which we were able to create. So now I would like Manisha Jain to continue this 100-day challenge story.
Thank you, Smriti. In the girls' school, which is present in the proximity of Kaman Sarai, we organized a drawing and essay writing competition where we asked students to make whatever comes to their mind when we talk about heritage. So few of the girls made the sketch of Kaman Sarai as they associate with the structure in the essay. Also, they were writing the sentiments connecting to the structures getting damaged. So there was also this perspective of looking at the heritage, which is present in the surroundings, that was achieved by the students. And to spread the word amongst the other people, we decided to play Nukkar Natak in Lodi Garden on World Heritage Day. What was achieved from the same? So that not only was the ICOMOS members are aware of the something like the Kaman Sarai, but at the same time, probably the school students wouldn't even know that Sarai is something. Even they started understanding the Sarai, and there was this excitement on their faces towards the new perspective of the heritage. We could see that change in the faces of children. On 27th April, 100 Day of 100 Day Challenge, we conducted a culmination day where we invited mayor and students of same girls' school. The event was supposed to be held in Kaman Sarai precinct. To get that place ready for the event, we first get it cleaned and ask people to not park their vehicles in the precinct for a day. And then we organized the rangoli making activity, which was performed by the girls from the same girls' school, where we have the presence of mayor as well. We were at least able to spread that message out through various activities which were carried out. So now the mayor and the MCG commissioner are also aware, and they are going to retain the Command Sarai part, which is a good outcome. Therefore, we were able to win some and lose some, and finally we were able to get that across. While our vision for the proposal was to conserve the fabric of Sarai and intervene with vocational center, book cafe, reading rooms, providing an exhibition area and provide a playground, but this existing scenario is this, we were at least able to save the Command Sarai structure. So we were envisioning the space as a public area, more like a cultural space, and we would have wanted to integrate the parking also. But this is the reality, and at least this part has been retained by our efforts. Therefore, the message through Command Sarai is that if we actually do these things, then we can make a difference. Now, I would like to hand over to Savar. Thank you.
Thank you, Samriti. Thank you, Manisha. Some very interesting perspectives and some action, finally. Samvedna, can I please request you to share the presentation? Share your screen.
Yes.
And I'm just seeing that a lot of more people have joined since we started. So welcome everyone again. Thanks, Samvedna. So what me and my colleague Samvedna will be talking about is the Gurgaon Masani village. So with the first semester studio, we'll be talking about our journey. The basic question of identification and understanding of built heritage had to be established. In the studio at the first semester level, we explored what is heritage. So the site that we worked on was the precinct of Masani. That is also the point of origin of Gurgaon. And as you can see, a lovely image of a facade of a Haveli. That the first time we went to the site, it immediately felt different. This was a place which seemed to have a lot of secrets, hidden heritage, and a lot of layers to unfold. The residents also that we encountered all had their strong associations to certain buildings. And also we came across typologies such as Havelis, which is a private courtyard residence, and Chopals, a community space, which we were also encouraged to experience by the residents. Can we have the next slide, please? We then started our journey of heritage, delving into an examination of Masani. Our focus was on mapping these interesting relationships that I previously spoke about between the people and their heritage and their oral narratives. We achieved this by going through the various stages of stakeholder mapping, study of values, by cross-examining them with charters. Now, charters are internationally accepted and validated documents for valuing heritage. So all my colleagues who've joined here who would like to join in, they will learn more about it once they join the course. And also, we were encouraged to use cutting-edge technologies like GIS, which made this process a lot more easier. And we in turn ended up developing a new skill, which is always fun. Learning never stops. Can we have the next slide, please? Further, as I spoke about the mapping, we understood the place from the regional level, zooming into the building level. So these are a few maps that you can see of the regional study that we did. We devised a format of inventory of buildings. Now, what inventory is actually, we thought it was just a standard listing, that listing, you know, what heritage buildings are there or what important built forms we can see there. But we referred various sources that, for example, Intac and others of various listings. But what we realized was that we thought it was a very technical process. But it wasn't actually, because we realized so much that so many new and important things that, you know, we went to the site. Next slide, please. So when we went to the site, as you can see on your screen, you know, these interesting symbols and, you know, these dance forms and this very interesting art form, some sculptures on some facades, we realized the different dimensions that this has brought to our thinking process of how we saw and analyzed the heritage around us. Things that we would otherwise maybe not question and not think about or would come to us immediately were clear because we asked the right questions. We realized in this process of how to map the tangible and the intangible. Next slide, please. So, of course, in mapping, there was a lot of continuous to and fro in terms of site visit. And we would alternate it, you know, with mapping, as it is a continuously evolving process, which might have had some moments of uncertainty, as Manisha and Samriti before me also mentioned. But it was certainly rewarding in the end when we saw our findings. Next slide, please. So what we did was, while we were doing community mapping, we came across the community of Kumhars, which is another one of the very interesting layers of this precinct. We thought of engaging with them. And this is one of among the many communities that live in Masani. And the potters live and work in Kumhar Gali. So there is a specific area which has been, which is occupied by them and where they work and where they live. So what we realized through our study was that while the craft finds a special place in the life of the village residents, it is declining due to various social and economic reasons. And the only economic boom that they have yearly is Diwali or the festive season. The entire year they suffer from lack of work, and hence the art of pottery was dwindling. Which was something that we found out after our investigation. So can I have the next slide, please? So what we did was we were able to create a connection with the Kumhars by creating a heritage photo walk activity and subsequently a hands-on workshop where the participants worked with clay hands-on, listening to the various narratives of the Kumhars. And, you know, they also explained that we've been doing this since long, and what the process is, and where they do what, and what kind of how technically difficult their art is actually. And also we saw the process of bhatti. You can see a small image of this on the left side, for which they have segregated a special open area in Masani, which we mapped. And all this was a part of the action that we took through learning, not letting it remain to the classroom. Next slide, please. We also did the study of the building conditions. So this is a slightly technical part of our work. So we thought of showcasing it. Next slide, please. And these are the lost typologies that I spoke about, the Havelis, the Chopals. There was also Chhatta, Apoli, and so many interesting typologies that we hadn't actually come across before, and one normally doesn't. Next slide, please. So moving towards the second semester, where we focused on sustaining heritage in terms of the lost typologies, we focused on the typologies of Haveli and Chopals. And we've also presented that research in our previous webinars. It's there on YouTube also, and it's there on all our social media also. Now I would like to hand it over to my colleague Samvedna, who will talk further about this. And she has worked in the brought her invaluable hands-on experience to the next part, which she shall be discussing about. So Samvedna, over to you.
Thank you, Sivan, and hello, everyone. During our second semester, we conducted a two-day workshop, which was a hands-on clay workshop and a lime plaster workshop. So a two-day workshop was conducted. One day was specially for SSA students, where they could learn the traditional practices of lime, and it was a hands-on workshop for the students. And on the second day, we conducted a workshop for locals specially, in which we did not hesitate to go door to door and collect, gather up people. And there were a lot of curiosity among the locals as well, because they did lack information about the traditional materials. They wanted to fill the gap that how they are going to they wanted to find a permanent solution for their repairs. They are obviously repairing their heritage homes and buildings with modern material due to lack of awareness and due to lack of availability of craftsmanship. And there was a lot of enthusiasm among the locals to understand what the traditional practices were. And we even created a small manual that what are the do's and don'ts of a lime structure. And on the right hand side, you can see that there was a lady who was very much interested to even, you know, try her hands on the material, that how these plasters are done. And we interacted with, for this, we even interacted with influential stakeholders such as the local councillor, and we incorporated these inputs in our proposals as well, our building level proposals as well, where we incorporated how the Kumars of the Kumar Gali should be highlighted, their arts and crafts should be highlighted along with generating library and skill centers for the youth. With all these actionable steps, we were able to create a potential model to generate awareness and reach out to multiple stakeholders, also have an opportunity to take it forward. We were truly able to take action through learning. I would like to hand over to Shreya, who will be explaining one of the other projects that we created, which was Sadar Bazaar. Over to Shreya.
Thank you, Samvedna. I'll just present my screen. Hello, everyone. After working in the field of architecture for almost 10 years and handling many live projects, I have recently started my journey in the field of heritage with Sushan University. When we all think what is heritage and what's exact concept behind the idea of heritage, we all have our own definition that connects us with our life events. Some people think that tourist destinations they visited our heritage. Some people think the childhood memories or their bedtime stories are the heritage for them. Some people even think making some learning some art or crafts is also heritage. Or people even think that even feel that celebrating different colorful festivals are also heritage. So this makes different definitions for all of us what is heritage. In last two semesters, we learned how to analyze different values connected to our heritage, its importance, and ultimately different ways of sustaining it through various classroom activities, outdoor excursions, and seminars. Our learning was focused not only on theoretical approach towards heritage, but also encouraging us to engage activities beyond the classroom. To share experience and brief you more about the journey, I would like to take you all through one very interesting project, which is nothing but the Sadar Bazaar of Gurgaon. This was an academic project done by our master's students in 2017 as a part of their semester one studio project. This semester was more focused on what is heritage or defining heritage. Sadar Bazaar is nothing but the marketplace or commercial zone located in vicinity of Old Gurgaon. Our seniors understand this crowded market site through various modes like regular site visits, photo, video documentation,
I think Shreya has lost some connectivity. So this was till she just joins back, and I can talk a little bit about the project. As this was a very interesting project actually, and In the current slide, you can see a few pictures taken by our senior batch of 2017 to 2019. During that site visit, that focuses on the build forms and the people and the hustle bustle of the street. So as you can see, the image, much like Chandni Chowk, the bazaar street is quite narrow. It's quite crowded. What happened was that during the site visits, as we also did, that there were a lot of live interviews of stakeholders that happened, like the shopkeepers, the residents, or even the frequent visitors, to understand their relation with the bazaar and some oral histories and memories, or even the issues that they are facing. So this whole process of collecting and analyzing data from various sources, as was in the case of Masani also, which I explained, always helps us to interpret the site holistically. I think while Shreya joins back, I'll share my screen, and I hope it's visible and you can see the presentation.
Yes.
Yeah. So the next part that we were going to talk about was that after visiting the site, the students did further analysis by understanding connectivity, contextual significance, physical parameters in the forms of various maps and documents. Now this data, this analytical data, this text is further converted into graphical representation to simplify the site. They also prepared plans that highlight heritage buildings, important chalks, open spaces, religious buildings, because we have to keep all those in mind when we come towards our proposals later. Also in this site, in this slide you can see that the activity mapping of the entire street was done, and you can see a plan of the street below with a detailed study of each and every building, considering aspects like occupancy, age, aesthetics, spatial planning, and this was another exercise. So the whole street was represented by creating a photo montage, because we do need to see holistically how the street looks, how the buildings work together. We can't just see it in isolation. As in the case of Masani also, the further study that was done, it was zoomed on to the building level. And we documented, the seniors documented a few prominent Havelis like Bhargava Haveli, like Goyal Haveli. And this helped them to understand the detailed architectural features. As you can see in the image, there's some beautiful patterns there. And also plans, site, sketches and site sections. Moving further, in July 2020, we got an opportunity to take this up actually as a live project when we were invited by the MCG commissioner to work in a team involving us, WRI, which is an NGO that has been working on urban development from the lens of mobility, and academics from DCRUST Murthal, which is a prestigious academic organization. It sort of became a multidisciplinary project for our university, where faculties and students from different departments work together, promoting interdisciplinary learning. The project involved experts from built heritage. There was students from interior architecture, masters, and also the SSD, which is the School of Design. As mentioned, team WRI mainly handled the mobility issues of the street, and team DCRUST handled the actual execution and the BOQs, or the bill of quantities that they have an expertise in. So in this slide, you can see that our approach towards this project was through different lenses. We as built heritage students studied and identified the current status of the Havelis that I just mentioned, old eateries which are serving food. There is a very very unique a jalebi place here. Also religious buildings in the precinct, which were like Jama Masjid, and also the temples. We, along with our faculties of IEA Interior Architecture and SSD, which is the School of Design, tried to create interesting interventions like street paving patterns. Wherever heritage is there, we try to highlight it. and also and translucent canopies at important chalks. You can see the three-dimensional model that we had made, and also drinking water facilities incorporating the concept of Piau, and also and many more such other interventions. We also considered the safety measures by providing these are the image of the paving that I mentioned. We also considered the safety measures by providing adequate street lighting, adding signage, because you know signage is there, but what we have to do is that we had to incorporate the signage. So you can see these yellow bands in the street lights that we were able to put, because it is good to give the shopkeepers a place to have that the signage, rather than having it haphazardly over the entire stretch. Also, design interventions, like you can see in the image, like trellis with plants at entry junctions, give a better sense of arrival, because you do need a sense of arrival, and you do need a sense of beginning and a sense of ending, which is currently missing in Sadar Bazaar. I don't know if you have ever visited it. Also, contributing in this live project was a very good learning for all of us, and this is still in process. So we hope to keep you all updated. Now, with this, I would like to hand it over to Tejaswini Rai and Rinalini Singh, who are again recent graduates and budding professionals. They will be sharing with us insights on Jharsa, which was another interesting collaboration. And may I please request you to share?
Thank you, Savar. Manisha, could you please share your screen with us? Good evening, everyone. The program EMARC Built Heritage of SSA, Sushant University, Gurgaon, adopts a participatory approach for the studios as well as for other projects. This approach provides a wider lens to us, the students, to look beyond the four walls and get an exposure of the field work. As a part of this, SSAA, in collaboration with Intact Gurugram chapter, signed a MOU for the project Conservation and Interpretation of Jean Etienne's Tomb, Jharsa, on 18th October 2018. SSA agreed to be the knowledge partner for the project. The tomb is associated with a French soldier of Begum Samru who ruled the Jharsa Badshahpur region in the 19th century. The tomb is situated inside the Mohial Colony Park, which is maintained by the Mohial Resident Welfare Society. The surviving tomb is one of the built structures of the 19th century, which reflects the cultural identity of Jharsa village during Begum Samru's reign, hence a significant built structure of the region. Next. This project was flagged off by the Deputy Commissioner on 28th October 2018 in presence of the residents of Mohial Colony, members of Intact Gurugram chapter, and SSAA team. The event had various interesting discussions among the different stakeholders on the initiatives taken up by them for safeguarding heritage, and intriguing insights were provided by the residents of the Mohial Colony on how they have been taking up maintenance of the tomb throughout its existence, which was also covered by Hindustan Times newspaper and later published in the same. Next. For the entire project, a research methodology was developed by the students of the college, which majorly involved secondary research, physical documentation, condition mapping, and conservation proposal. A study of the immediate physical and social context was also undertaken to establish issues and opportunities. We not only studied the images, next. We, the students, not only studied the immediate site, but also to understand the setting of the tomb in a larger context, we tried and identified any other structures of historic significance in Jharsa village to enable tying together with the tomb in question as a part of heritage walks. This study made us realize how important it is to understand the site holistically rather than concentrating on the single build structure. Next. During the recce of Jharsa village, we were able to locate different build structures in the village of different architectural typology. The structure we identified were kacheri, which was used as a meeting point during revolt of 1857 to discuss different strategies, Lal Kua, Chhatri, next slide. Chhatri, which is currently being used as a cow shed, and many other structures. Looking at the conditions of all these structures made us realize how heritage exists in people's everyday life, and they still choose to neglect and ignore it, and how we as conservation professionals can try and fill in these gaps by generating awareness among the people and not let these structures be lost with time. Next. This life project was a mini exercise done apart from our studios. We were a batch of 7 girls, and none of us had any idea how the entire conservation process works. There were several new aspects we learned during this project, starting from photographic documentation to measured drawings and ultimately condition assessment. The most challenging part of this whole process for us was documenting the uppermost portion of the tomb, that is the finial, which you can all see in the 2 pictures. Whatever pictures that we had did not show us the intricate detailing on the finial. So with zero knowledge on how to get better pictures, we decided to take help of the neighboring shop and ask for a CD, the staircase. And without thinking too much, climbed onto it and tried to click as clear pictures as we could. The next difficult task was to understand what is written on the plaque of the tomb. So one of us started tracing it using a paper and pencil, and whatever we could decipher out of it was through this technique. These small incidents made us aware that we need to be quick on thinking on site, and not everything can be taught through theory, and a hands-on approach is equally important. And I'm glad that our teachers had faith in us and had given us the freedom to explore rather than just spoon feeding us on every step of the project. Next. The major learning from this project that we all had was how to showcase the existing conditions of the built heritage on paper. I personally find condition assessment the most interesting part of the entire process, as we can get to mark each and every layer of the structure in detail. Next. So during most of our site visits, we always had discussions and interactions with the residents of the Mohiyal colony regarding their take on the tomb, during which we found the Mohiyal Welfare Association tried to repair the structure with whatever knowledge they had, which ultimately harmed the structure more. While their heart was in the right place, but due to the lack of awareness regarding the upkeep and maintenance of heritage structure, it led them to use broken tiles and cement to repair it. So the major issue here was the awareness on safeguarding the built heritage. So all the proposals that we proposed was focused on improving the lack of awareness among the different stakeholders. Next. We, the students, did all the site work and research for the span of 6 months with our studio exercises and prepared a report for the same, which was then recompiled and re-edited by our faculties. The entire process took around 2 years to complete, from 2018 to 2020. A detailed project report was prepared by the faculty, which was then shared with INTAC convener, Mr. Atul Dev sir, which was highly appreciated by all the INTAC members. We all are so proud of the work that we prepared and all the hard work that has been paid off when the report was applauded by the French embassy. And to show their appreciation of the work produced by us, they have proposed a small sum for the conservation of the tomb. So the overall learning that we all, the students gained from this was how this project helped in understanding how a built structure needs to be dealt in an urban setting, the technical know-how, and how much it is important for the involvement of various stakeholders for a project to succeed. The entire process helped us to know what step needs to be taken for sustaining heritage or an unprotecting built heritage. The knowledge gained from this live project then reflected back on various studio projects, including the one which was showcased in this presentation, Command Sarai. At the end, I would just like to thank all our faculty and all the members associated with this project for giving us this amazing opportunity and to see one of our initiation to conserve and protect a structure actually take off in reality with such flying colors. Thank you so much, Sabar.
Thank you, Mrinalini. That was very interesting to know about the finial and how we always need to be quick in our thinking at the site. You know, because some decisions that we take have to be immediate, and not everything can be followed through a process. So this presentation concludes our initiatives on action through learning. I would like to also take this opportunity to mention that our Dean Dr. Vibhuti Sachdev has always been behind us as a guiding force and an inspiration to become change makers and to create a real difference on the ground. With this, may I please request Vibhuti ma'am that if she could share a few words of her vision and any views that she might.
Okay, thank you, Sawar. So we've got quite a full house. It'll be nice if people can turn their videos on, and have the human contact alive. Thank you. Lovely to see you all. Thank you. So I think it's a great forum. Not just educational, but also, as Sawar said, we can, through education, make a difference to our environment. And, everything is about action. We've taken action very seriously. Action is related to our karma. So it's like you take a wrong action and it'll chase you for 7 lives. So people have been very concerned about, what action do you take? And education gives you that reflective space to work out that action. Now, in other disciplines where new things are in the making, it's a different kind of thought process. So if you're building something new, then the action is different. But in case of built heritage, it's a very, very sensitive space, and it's a very... it's a space that demands a lot of consideration, because you're dealing with you're approaching with a live body, and you need to, and which requires surgery. So you need to be very sure as to what surgery you're going to do, so that the body of heritage that is in front of you is alive and is revitalized. So that kind of action requires a lot of learning, which we provide in the degree program, because you can't just get up and take action and think, was this action okay? You can't take those risks. You have to reflect on actions. You have to think about what are the various types of actions, and whether your action is a reaction to something, whether it's a response, whether it's reuse, whether it's your action is meant to stop an action which is deteriorating the environment. So all these diverse actions we need to kind of we study in our studio, and we ponder upon and on all these actions, and sometimes even to make an action which is about inaction, it has to be considered, so, to not do anything is also an action. So, so these are the various, nuances of what we do through projects. And we provide that also the safety net, so that, whatever we do in our projects is meaningful and enriching, not just to our students, but to communities who use those areas. So we believe firmly, that these buildings have a life in them through the people who use them, through the communities who live around them. So they have a meaning and purpose around it. So we look at it, we try and look at it in a very holistic way. So with that cultural belief that action is karmic, so we need to kind of take our actions very seriously, and that's why we study. So and I wish you all the best, and I hope you will join us in this very enriching degree program, which has this immediacy of improving the environment, you know. So it has that satisfaction that, you know, you can actually get up and do something about your environment, which very few degree programs do in this country. And so once you do that, you know, you take ownership of your city, you take ownership of your environment, and you can feel your energy making a difference in the environment. And that's very special. That's very special to have. So all the best, all of you, and hope to see you on campus soon. Meanwhile, we'll continue interaction online. So let us know if you have any further questions or you want to talk to me. I'm at the end of a wire, and I'm always available. And you know, the lovely alumni and students and faculty as well. So happy Teachers Day to all of you.
Thank you.
I would like to mention here that Samruti and Tejasvi have also become teachers now. So happy Teachers Day to them for sure. Specifically.
Thank you.
Somebody was saying, this is a side, I'll only take 30 seconds because it's very interesting. So somebody said to me, you know, why are you wishing me a happy Teachers Day? I'm not a teacher. But you know, in our culture, you know that, you know, when a child is born or it's a child's birthday, you wish everybody happy birthday. Because it's celebrating Teachers Day. It's not about a personal Teachers Day. And you know, teachers are born because of the students. It's not, it can't be other way. So it's all of us have to celebrate kind of a community happy Teachers Day. And it's Radhakrishnan's birthday, who was a great scholar and a great, you know, fountainhead of wisdom, that and who has taught us so many things, you know, through his writings, through, he translated the Upanishads. And what a president to have in our country. It was a very special time, and it'll come back again. So we commemorate scholarship and tradition and heritage, because he worked on heritage. He worked on textual heritage all his life, and he was a great Sanskrit scholar as well. So again, happy Teachers Day. I could go on. But
absolutely. So I think Shreya had a little bit of a connection issue.
Yeah, extremely sorry to all of you.
Anything you'd like to add? Anything you'd like to add as a final note, Shreya?
I guess thanks to Sawar, who did the presentation on behalf of me. Thank you very much. And extremely sorry for all of you. But definitely we learn a lot in last two semesters through our different activities, not only the classroom lectures and the sessions in classroom, but of course we did lots of activities outside the classroom, like workshops, pottery workshops. And actually we all, we were happy to arrange also all those workshops, to go there to talk with people, how can you conduct this workshop with us and all that. That was very good experience for us. So it's not only going there and doing understanding or learning pottery, but it's the whole experience was very interesting. So yeah, definitely that will connect us more with the village and the people over there. So that was very good experience.
Thank you, Shreya. Piyush, anything you would like to add?
Yeah, I mean, it's always really nice to see, you know, all these things that we have been involved with, and, you know, I was enjoying it. But, you know, being a part of the whole process also, I was like, oh, that was so interesting. And, you know, you go back in time and remember, like, the Kaman Sarai, you know, we're cleaning the floors, we're, you know, because log aayenge abhi, I mean, be it the school program for Kaman Sarai, we did, it was so much of fun. And also, the Masani village with the current batch, I mean, every time we go there, the workshops and everything. So I had fun being a part as a faculty and also as a student. You know, we learn from everything and we keep on learning. And all these four projects that we just discussed, the students-led things, I mean, be it the Jharsa project also, I mean, you know, how to sort of involve the stakeholders and, you know, all those things we did, lots of work we did. So it was fun. And I'm looking forward to many, many more associations like that. Yeah.
So thank you, Piyush. And Tapasya has just joined in, I think. She lost connection in the middle. Tapasya, would you like to add a few words? Tapasya has been a part of part of our team, you know, working on heritage and the projects particularly. So maybe, I don't know, there's some.
Probably some network.
Yeah.
Sorry. I am facing some network issues. There's a lot of darkness outside suddenly, clouds. So, I have been associated with both the batches somewhat little bit, but my feeling is that they never stop themselves at how many people around us, how many hands to do something, and I think that's a very positive spirit for groups to work together. It's not how much work to be distributed, but yes, what is to be done. So that's actually a great I would say it's a great quality that these students have. Their approach to everything, trying to be as professional as possible, trying not to question, we are students, we should not be doing this, maybe I don't know how to do this. So that I think is a great I would say it's a reflection of how their faculty behaves with them probably, and how much they are pulled up for presenting things which probably are not their best. So I wish all the best of luck. I've probably interacted with all of you, almost all of you, and I see that you'll have a great and bright future, and probably compete with us in the field and take away some projects from us, and that will be really, really, really the reward for teaching you guys. So good luck with that, and hope to see many more of such interactive things, and your contribution to Gurgaon or in larger part Haryana's heritage and where you take it. Yeah, good luck.
Thank you, ma'am. Paru ma'am, I think you're on mute.
Oh, sorry. So just wondering if Professor Bhavna Danduna would be able to, if the internet allows her to share a few words.
Yeah, Barul, thank you. I was just listening to all of us, saying different things about the program. But yes, I really feel deeply about the program since its inception, day one, how we've been looking forward to having our first batch, and now we are in the third one. And the learning has been great for us, not just for students, for every step we've learned immensely. And I really look forward to them graduating and going out, people asking us for references, how your students are. I think the engagement has been very, very fruitful, and I look forward to the new batches, teaching them and learning with them. It's not really, I actually, by third semester, I tell them, I'm not going to teach you anything. This is like a project, and we are all co-workers. So, that's how we work in the third semester, by the time they're ready to take on their thesis. So yeah, I've had a lovely time, and I hope we keep doing this in the future. Sorry, I am in an environment where I can't talk too much, but all the best.
Thank you, ma'am.
So perfect. I think we had a, like Piyush mentioned, it was a fantastic, moment where we were sitting back and listening to you all. So very happy to be in that position where you're the stars of the show. And, we are always happy to see the spirit, the passion, the motivation, and whether it's for the batch that has passed out or the batch that has just moved to second year, I think we have to keep the spirit going, and we have to continue to be whatever we can be. Like Tapasya said, that, are we cleaners? Are we activists? Are we, so we are all a bundle of everything in a package. So let's keep the spirit alive, and let's take on the next semester and the forward journey of our professional life, forward, ahead. So thank you very much, Savar. I think we can close the session now.
Yes, ma'am. So just to add to this, before closing, I would like to say that, our previous webinars and all our previous research is available on our social media also, if anyone would like to access that. We are at Build Heritage on Twitter and Instagram, and we are at Our Build Heritage on Facebook and LinkedIn, and also on YouTube on Sushant University and SSA Live. Our previous webinars where we have shared our research and our experiences are also available. And with this, I would like to thank everyone and close this session, and looking forward to many more, and hopefully going to college physically also soon. Thank you.
Yes, definitely.
Thank you, Sabha. Thank you all.
Thank you all.
Have a nice evening.